I want to dedicate this to you that I love very much. I want to thank Dexter and all of you.
Sometimes, just getting out of bed in the morning is the hardest part of your day. What inspires us to make that small leap from sleep to success? Believe it's possible. Think of the goal you are trying to achieve. Maybe you've had some setbacks or have already given up and just need some encouragement to get started again. There may be winners and losers, but you maybe just haven't discovered how to win and need some encouragement. Go out and find someone who will support you. Seek insight and strategies that will open your path to the future. Think about what's important and what you want, and don't just assume you can do it, because if you want something bad enough, go out and work for it. You need to fight for it and sacrifice. If you are able to sweat to achieve your personal success and lose your fear of trying, go after it with everything that you have. If you do seek out support, practice the principle of only quality people. It's a full-time job just trying to change yourself, so don't try and change other people too. But you can't only rely on others. Never stop educating yourself. Expand your mind and challenge it by investing in you. You have greatness inside because you are like no other person on this planet. Teaching others can be easy, but practicing what you preach is the hard part. Do this by believing in what you do. No matter where you come from, you have something of value to offer to others. Learn from those who came before you and let them inspire you. And if you want to do something, go out there and do it.
I could do more than I was now experiencing.
The easiest thing that I do is speak and train people how to speak. Go into prisons and juvenile detention centers and to high schools and colleges. Speak before thousands of people. I can do that in my sleep. Let me share with you the most difficult thing I've ever done in my life. And it took me years to do. And that was to believe that it was possible. To believe that I can do it. Given my circumstances, born in an abandoned building on a floor. Being adopted, being labeled educable, mentally retarded, failing twice in school, no college training, never worked for a major corporation, to believe that I had something of value to say, that somebody would want to listen to me, to believe that somebody would pay me to talk to them. Have you ever thought about something you wanted to do and you talk yourself out of it? I remember going to see Zig Ziegler, who I consider the number one motivational speaker on the planet, and Dr. Norman Vincent Peale when he was alive, and Robert Schuller. I used to see them and I would be so pumped up and inspired after hearing Jim Rohn, who recently passed, one of the great motivational speakers of all time, and Charlie Tremendous Jones. And I would go to my car pumped up, saying, yes, 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 I can. And then after a while, my mental conditioning would kick in. And would say, Les Brown, you can't do that.
I want you to look at something right now. Think of some major goal you want, or maybe it's one you're already working on, and you have experienced a lot of setbacks, a lot of defeats. You've experienced a lot of disappointment. Maybe you've already given up. And maybe you just need a little fire, a little encouragement to get back in the game again. Here's what I want you to look at. There are winners, and there are losers, and there are people who have not discovered how to win. And all they need is some coaching. All they need is some help and assistance, just a little support. All they need is some insight or a different strategy, a plan of action to make some adjustments that will open up the key to a whole new future for them, that will give them access to the unlimited power that they have within themselves. That's all that they need. So what I want you to do is think about something you want for you, that's real for you, that's important for you, that will give your life some special meaning and power. And I don't even want you to say, I can do that. I don't want you to assume that. See, 5 years ago, when I started out in this area, I would not have been able to make the mental leap that I would be up to where I am right now.
So practice the principle of OQP, only quality people. And somebody's saying, Les, can I change them? No, it's a full-time job changing yourself. Some people are so negative, they'll walk into a dark room and begin to develop. My family members and friends call me crazy for going to seminars, spending money on books and tapes and going to seminars. When are you going to stop going? I said, when I die. When does a man or a woman die? When their dreams die. When do we die? When we stop developing ourselves, expanding our minds, challenging ourselves, raising the bar on ourselves. The best thinking that I had at that point in my life, it produced this life that I have. I need some help on where Einstein was. He said, the thinking that has brought me this far has created some problems that this thinking can't solve. I applaud you for investing in yourself, for coming here, flying thousands of miles, investing money in yourself. I can tell you, based upon my own experience, you have something special. You have greatness within you. What you're doing is different. You represent only 2% of the planet.
I want to dedicate this to you that I love very much. I want to thank Dexter and all of you. It's something that I'm known by. It's on our tapes called Choosing Your Future, and it says simply this, that if you want a thing bad enough to go out and fight for it, to work day and night for it, to give up your time, your peace, and your sleep for it, if all that you dream and scheme is about it, and life seems useless and worthless without it, and if you gladly sweat for it and fret for it and plan for it and lose all your terror of the opposition for it, and if you simply go after that thing that you want with all of your capacity, strength and sagacity, faith, hope, and confidence, and stern pertinacity, if neither cold poverty, famish, or gulf, sickness, or pain, or body and brain can keep you away from the thing that you want.
Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more content.